We gather to give thanks for the gift of marriage, to witness the joining together of Kathleen and Dave, to surround them with our prayers and best wishes, and to ask God's blessing upon them so that they may be strengthened for their life together. Marriage was created so that you both may help and comfort each other, living faithfully together in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, throughout all of your days. Your marriage is the full expression of your love. In marriage, Kathleen and Dave belong to each other, and with affection and tenderness, freely give themselves to each other. In marriage, you will be joined together and become one. You are now called to a new way of life, created and blessed by God. This way of life must not be entered into carelessly or from selfish motive, but responsibly and prayerfully. Kathleen and Dave, your journey is just beginning. Not only are you here to profess your love for each other, but you have the joy of sharing this extraordinary moment with the people you care for the most. The two of you have certainly picked a gorgeous location and a special place for this wedding. I know, Dave, Grandfather Mountain holds a special meaning to you and your family. This is a place where you've done many a hike, played many a round of golf, and developed your love of rock climbing. And you've shared this beautiful place with Kathleen, just as she has enjoyed sharing our family respite and her happy place at Paula's Island, South Carolina with you. Both of these places really signify family and a gathering place for friends. What an appropriate location for your wedding. Several months ago, when you asked me to officiate your wedding ceremony, I was honored and humbled to say yes. Kathleen, I held you in my arms when you were born. And it's been a delight to watch you grow into such a beautiful young woman. I've always so admired your confidence, your individuality, and your quirky humor, a true Cohen brand trait. Although I've not known Dave near as long, I have been around him long enough to know that you have finally met your match, Kathleen. To find your soulmate is a true blessing. And today, as you exchange your wedding vows, I want you to remember something that you both told me in preparing this short meditation. I asked both of you, what makes you both believe that you're right for each other? What do you believe makes for a long, successful marriage? And both of you answered the question in the exact same way. We really love spending time together. I get to marry my best friend. Almost everyone here knows where your journey began. The Queen City, Charlotte became the first place where you met. Watching a Panthers game with mutual friends. Then weeks later, that first date. But Charlotte was the place where your journey began and where you got to really know each other and make that commitment in your relationship. Over these past years, as your relationship has grown, you've discovered many joint interests. One of those, the love of travel. And boy, travel you have. Not only to Grandfather Mountain and Paula's Island, but to Spain and France and England and the Virgin Islands, the Dominican Republic, and the list goes on. You find a lot about a person when you travel with them. Weird quirks, likes and dislikes, who's the organizer, who's the trip planner, who's the navigator. As your relationship grew, you also learned to share responsibilities, a prelude to marriage, and found out much more about each other. Kathleen cooks, Dave cleans. Kathleen's the type A personality, while Dave's a bit more laid back. Dave is a bit more extroverted, but both of you are competitive and have a healthy dose of sarcasm in your humor. All of your friends agree that you both are loyal to a fault, are great listeners, and meet the true definition of friend. Your marriage is destined for success. You know, it is nothing short of a miracle that you found each other in your life journey. Your grand sense of humor, your passion for life, and your zest for life is what has sealed your relationship. As you set off on this exciting and wonderful marriage journey, use these words as a brief job description of your married life. Always be considerate. Be trusting. Be joyful and celebrate each other, remembering that in many ways, our lives are measured by the size of our heart, by our vulnerability, and by our openness. Practice the art of patience, kindness, and tenderness. Always laugh easily and often. Show appreciation for each other. Be ever quick to forgive and slow to anger. Remember the good times and be appreciative. And finally, forget the things that should be forgotten and move on together. These are some of the skills and practices that truly make up the art of loving.
I, Dave, take you, Kathleen, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
I, Kathleen, take you, Dave, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and bad, in sickness and in health. I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
May the love of God surround you. May you live in faith, abound in hope, grow in love, both now and forevermore. Amen. You may kiss the bride. I introduce to you Mr. and Ms. Dave Keatley.
Thank you all for coming to celebrate in this beautiful location, Grandfather Mountain Country Club. Kathleen, Katie, you will always be my little baby girl. I will have an eternal vision of you digging with your toes in the mud at Polly's Island. I loved watching you grow. Your adult journey began in Charlotte, where you forged new relationships and new friendships. Through these friendships, you met Dave. And with Dave, as Danny said earlier, you've met your match. He's intelligent, he's adventurous, and ambitious. Dave, Kath and I are ecstatic and proud to call you son. Kathleen, Mom and I will always be there for you. Dave is now your rock, and we are only a FaceTime call away.
Since college, Kathleen and I have never lived in the same city, but we haven't gone a year without seeing each other. Charlotte, Washington, D.C., Denver, Boston, now Pittsburgh, now Phoenix. It's going to be great. For everyone that knows Kathleen, she's as great a person as they come. You're the most loyal friend that anybody could ever have, and it always inspires and pushes you to be the best version of themselves. Dave, the happiness that I see in her when she is around you is something that fills my heart with so much joy. To Dave and Kathleen, may you know nothing but happiness, love, and an ever-present sense of adventure. That's all. Cheers to the married couple.
I don't have enough words or time to explain how proud I am of these two young people and how excited I am for the journey on which they're about to embark. It's a journey in which they'll share kindness, respect, caring, and encouragement as they chase their dreams. We're so pleased that they found each other and that they found something within each other that led them to this place, the jumping off point for an extraordinary life together. You have my congratulations, my best wishes, and my love to David and Kathleen.
Now, living a quiet life. It's you and me now. We've been burned once or twice. I say, ooh.